Thank you. Thank you everyone for coming. My name is Dan Seynave. I'm a software engineer for Open Analytics. I think a lot of people already know Open Analytics, and those that don't, I welcome you to visit our booth at the ground floor to play some petanque and talk about R. But today I want to talk to you about two R packages I've written, or I'm still writing. Software is never finished. And I want to give a disclaimer that I'm not that good at naming things. So a colleague of me asked me that R developers always tend to put either an R before or after things. So what would happen if you write a package for a technology that starts with an R? So yeah, this happened. But I'm open to better suggestions if somebody has a better idea. So these are two packages to integrate with two very established tools in the continuous integration, delivery, and deployment scene, Jenkins and Rundeck. So these are two R packages that interact with the APIs offered by those tools to simplify working with them from an R environment. But before I get to that, I want to introduce you to the running example that I'll be using, which is the deployment of containerized Shiny apps. This is something that happens on a daily basis in Open Analytics. We write Shiny apps for a lot of clients. We are Open Analytics, it's a consulting company in diverse sectors. Sometimes we work on our own infrastructure. Sometimes we build something on the infrastructure of the client that has to integrate with tools that are existing there. So we need it for like a pattern of setting up a continuous integration pipeline where that's modular in its nature, so that we can add some of our own tools. We can use some of the tools that the client already has. But to walk you through the example is to so to deploy a containerized Shiny app. So first of all, you need to write a Shiny app. Then we always recommend to package a Shiny app, which has its advantages, but I won't go into detail there. Then the steps are to build that package, check the package, test the package, test the Shiny app as well. And then onto the containerization, you need to write a Docker file, you need to build the Docker image, and then finally you need to deploy Docker image. These are the steps that can be automated. And so to rephrase the goal, we want to have a continuous integration and continuous delivery. Note that I'm using CD for continuous delivery. It's sometimes confusing because both CD can refer to both continuous delivery and continuous deployment. The difference is that continuous deployment, whenever you make a commit and everything checks out, it's automatically deployed, while with continuous delivery, you still have a manual step at the end. We needed a continuous integration and continuous delivery pipeline that's fully open source. The open in Open Analytics is there for a reason, that can be self-hosted on any infrastructure. And the constraint I wanted to add to that for myself is that it's fully controllable from R. And our solution usually simplified looks a little bit like this. The main things that are usually there are a Jenkins and a Rundeck server, some kind of Git server, can be GitHub, can be GitHub Enterprise, can be a Bitbucket server, can be any other Git server like GitLab or... So the idea is that whenever a commit happens, it's automatically checked out by Jenkins, the build server, if I go back to the steps, who will do the building, the checking, testing of the package and the app, and then after that also build the Docker image, possibly also quickly test the Docker image. And once Jenkins is done, then he will push to a Docker registry. Can be Docker Hub or can be a custom Docker registry. We've deployed custom registries both in our own infrastructure and sometimes also to we also push to Docker registries that are already in place at a client. And then finally, whenever a deployment needs to happen, we usually insert a tool called Rundeck. And Rundeck, sometimes there's a bit of confusion. I'll go into further detail as what to the difference is to Jenkins. Jenkins is a build server, while Rundeck is more focused on operations. But I'll get into to more detail. And then going back to the running example, usually when we build containerized Shiny apps, we deploy them to Shiny proxy. So to give you a bit of background on Jenkins. So Jenkins is a continuous integration or build server. The primary purpose is to build artifacts. There is a web interface to configure several types of jobs. These are stored in XML format. And by default, Jenkins does not store job configuration under version control, although there is R plugins for that. And on the right, you see a picture of what Jenkins looks like when you're defining a what's called a freestyle job. And I asked to a colleague of mine who is a data scientist what her first impression was when she was faced with a tool like Jenkins, because she was recently introduced to the continuous integration paradigm, and her answer was help. And I think it's a common response because it's not immediately clear what you need and what you don't need in an interface like this. Which brings us to Jenkins 2. So over time, the Jenkins community has developed a set of plugins that work together to give rise to what's called Jenkins 2, where everything is based around the concept of pipelines. Pipelines are a more general type of job or workflow definition, and these are file-based. So here you can see an example of such a Jenkins file. And the syntax that they are written in is the Groovy scripting language. It's actually a second iteration of this Jenkins file. The first iteration was replaced, not fully, but by what's called a declarative syntax. And this is what I've put an example of here, for example. Two steps for an R package, which could be to Roxygenize, so to generate the documentation from Roxygen commits, and then to build the package. And if not put in more steps because my slide is only so high. But the advantage is as well that these Jenkins files, these live together next to the code under version control, which has its advantages. Then to go on to Rundeck, the second tool. So this is an operation server, and the primary idea is that you turn procedures into self-service operations. So for example, instead of SSHing into a server, pulling a Docker image there, restarting some service, you automate that through Rundeck, and then you have a web interface where somebody can go to, click a play button, and then select any number of nodes to which an operation needs to apply. And the big advantage of Rundeck as well is that it's designed to be aware of the environment you're running against, and there's plugins for Ansible, SaltStack, and things like that. And so, because it's a very versatile tool, that's why we keep coming back to it, both in our own pipelines and in client pipelines. Then to go on to the R packages that I've written. So the first one is R Jenkins, and you can see an overview of the basic commands. So as I said, in Jenkins, things revolve around these jobs. So after connecting or creating an object to connect to the Jenkins interface with a token, I can then list jobs. There's not that many here. Jenkins also has views, which allows to group these jobs. So all that's is supported in the package. And then I can schedule builds, look at summary of a job, which will show you an overview of the latest builds and which ones failed, which ones didn't. All of these functions have further arguments that allow you to go into detail. There's also a get build log function, which allows you to retrieve a log of a particular build. You can also list the artifacts that were produced. There's a couple of other features. For example, you can also directly install packages from Jenkins, which could be useful if you want to install the latest version that built correctly. Well, typically you would go on to push a package to like some sort of repository and then install from there. Then to come back to this Jenkins file, this Groovy syntax is nice, but a lot of R programmers don't want to learn yet another syntax. So I thought that if I can't change the language, I might as well change the syntax. So I wrote a domain-specific language to write Jenkins files in more typical R statements. So this is an example of the same Jenkins file you saw before, but using R functions, which are only defined within this pipeline statement to avoid cluttering your namespace. And then here is the statement to create a job with a given pipeline, but that's not the best approach. Usually, as I said, you would run to write this Jenkins file as a file in the repository and commit that to your repository. So that brings us to multi-branch jobs. Multi-branch jobs are also a new feature in Jenkins 2 that allow you to automatically scan branches in your repository and automatically create jobs for every branch. So also this is supported in the package, and here is an example of creating such a multi-branch configuration project. Using GitHub. Then there's also our rundeck, which has similar commands. I won't go too into detail here. I'd rather continue on to a live demo, and hopefully this will work because I'm using a French keyboard, an operating system I don't know, an IDE I don't know. So let's hope. So let's start by showing Shiny Proxy. There's a hello application. I need to log in. So this is just a basic Shiny example you all know and love. And then I have an RStudio Cloud session open where I will first create a connection with Jenkins, then write a Jenkins file, which I've written here. It's a little bit more complex than the one in the slides, but I've written it as this. Jenkins file So which looks like that, and also inline R statements are supported, which will properly escape everything. So you can actually include R code, arbitrary R code, in your pipeline. And then I want to go into the app and change something. Let's go here. Let's change the title. Hopefully I have enough time. I didn't save the file, okay, sorry, thanks. Okay, so it's committed. So then I can run this create job statement, schedule a build. So it's currently building. Can check logs, but maybe we can go to questions and maybe after I can show that it was indeed updated on the page.
So, round of applause, thank you. So we have time for one very quick question. That's good, because I've got one. So you're using Jenkins, and I hear all the cool kids use Travis and all those sorts of things. So what's the difference between Jenkins and Travis, and does it really matter? And
I will go back to my second slide. The second bullet points, an important thing for us is that everything can be self-hosted. Well, I think Travis can be self-hosted, but it's a little bit more difficult to get up and running self-hosted than Jenkins. And other than that, we also have a lot of Java experience, so it makes it easy for us to write custom plugins, for example, for Jenkins.
Okay, thank you. So you've got, if it works, you've got 5 seconds. I don't know if we do drum rolls. Success sounds good.
So it's pulling the image. There's the log. I need to sign out because otherwise it will serve me the same container again as an optimization.
So I think we can all go and check ourselves if it works.
I've put everything on Amazon just for this demo, so I'll just go to my laptop and take the whole thing down. So you're out of luck. Yeah.